Hello everyone, in this video we will learn how to compute the future value of ordinary simple annuities using a financial calculator. The financial calculator we're using is a Texas Instruments BA2+. So in the given problem, we are to compute the future value given the monthly deposit of $450. The interest rate was 7.5% compounded monthly. So first off, how do we know if it's a simple annuity or a general annuity? So here, when it says the payments are made at the end of each payment period, which is monthly payments, this end makes it ordinary. Second is the number of payments per year is 12 because the payments are monthly and interest is compounded monthly, right? So number of payments per year or PY is 12. Number of compounding periods per year, or CY, is 12. These two numbers match, and therefore it is a simple annuity. The investment term is 10 years, so T is 10 years. We're going to be using this T to calculate the number of payments in the total term. Before we enter in the values, as you know, we need to clear the TVM worksheet. We press second, and we press FV. Clear TVM is a secondary function on FV key. All right, so now we start entering the other values. We begin by entering number of payments per year and number of compounding periods per year. In order to do that, we press second and press I key to go to PY CY worksheet. Number of payments per year is 12 because the payments are monthly. 12, and we press enter. Now, every time you change number of payments per year, number of compounding periods per year changes automatically to the same number. You can double check by using the down arrow here and see that CY is also 12, okay? So for simple annuities, these two numbers are exactly the same. For general annuities, however, we need to change CY after changing PY. All right, so in order to exit the PYCY worksheet, we can press clear twice, or you can press second and press CPT key to quit the worksheet. All right, now for the rest of the values, in order to enter, we type in the number first and then we press the corresponding key. N is the total number of payments in the whole term, which is the number of payments per year, which is PY, multiplied by the number of years in the term, which in this case is T and is 10 years. So 12 multiplied by 10 makes it 120 total payments in the investment term. So we type in 120, then press N. And as you can see, this equal sign means 120 is stored in N key. Now, we press clear and we input the nominal interest rate, which is 7.5%. That's the interest rate per year. So 7.5, and you don't have to include the percent symbol. You don't have to convert this to decimal. You just input the rate itself and then press I. Next, we enter the payment. So the size of periodic payment is $450. Because it's investment and $450 is cash outflow, it should be entered as a negative number. So in order to change the sign, we use this positive negative sign key. And then press PMT. Now we clear the sheet and finally we compute the future value. In order to do that, we press compute button here, right, and press FV, and there you go. So the future value of this annuity is 80,068. If we are to round off this number to nearest cents, then it'd be 80,068 and 65 cents.